Today, the Ferrari 599 Formula D is available for us to unlock. All we have to do is complete this seasonal championship.
And a lot of people are here as well to do the exact same. So let's get on with it solo.
There's a Lamborghini right there. Why am I not driving the Lamborghini? Well, it's a Ferrari. Wait. Oh, I get it. Am I the only Ferrari? So far, everyone else is just in Huracan. I didn't check the list. I should have had a quick glance at the list. I think there's a Ferrari right ahead of us. So it might be two Ferraris with a few Lamborghini Huracans, to say the very least. Few events to get through. Smash through these, and we should have unlocked our brand new vehicle. A few modifications later, this is the state of the car. We're going to be finishing this event right here, which should give us the Ferrari 599 Formula D across the line smoothly, like butter, like a Ferrari with a lot of downforce. Except, and now we should receive our prize, which is the newest drift car in the game, which I have high hopes for. I have high hopes that it's going to be easy, smooth, reliable. The Formula D 599.
Let's get cooking!
Fun little fact for you, this is actually the only Formula D car that I decided to unlock. So we have nothing to compare it to, we're on a blank slate, but it looks fantastic. Look at the arches. It's also a ghost. Apparently, can have things drive through it. It's that quick that nothing can touch it. Get it? Did you get it? All right, without further ado, quick listen. Holy... We have a friend. Thankfully, that was a glitch. Okay, that was just a temporary glitch. It's fixed now. Hello, hello, hello. Nice to see you. 3, 2, 1. Give it the beans. He's driving backwards. Holy, this actually feels really stable. Okay, you know the difference between when a player makes a tune of a car and when they add a car like this in, a proper car like this, you feel like that front grip still. You don't normally feel the front grip when a player makes a drift car. When they make a special car for that scenario, these things feel amazing. They definitely put a different kind of handling model on these. You can replicate it somewhat, but just out the gate, this thing is ready to slide. This is so cool though. We got someone to drift with. I'm actually going to be drifting with my buddy over here. We're going to call him Platt. He's actually trying to go for some crazy wide angle skids. He's lost it a little bit there. Go on, Platt. Take the lead, Platt. Oh, it sounds so good in the interior view. And I forgot we actually have that new drift cam as well, which is going to give us some craziness. Now, obviously, it's all well and good driving it as is, but there are things you want to do to a vehicle. You don't want to just keep it as standard. You want to play with it, change it up a little bit. You can be so aggressive with this car, and it just takes it on the chin. It takes it. Part of me doesn't want to ruin it, but part of me kind of does at the same time. Come on, Platt. He's properly going for it. Come on, it's the UK. All the yobbos do it. All the chavs do it. They have a little bit of a skid round a roundabout. Come on, let's give it a go. The other day I was drifting with a wheel around the roundabout and I did have quite a bit of trouble, to be honest. It is quite a skill, especially to do it stable. But this is having no trouble. We're going to have to try this with a Thrustmaster. Throw it in, give it a go. This is mega. This is mega. Okay, without further ado, let's get back to the garage and give it a little bit of a... I was going to say a tune, but we're gonna ruin it, really. Now, as we expected, not really many things you could do to a vehicle like this. Of course, it's already had quite a bit done to it, to say the least. So we can do a conversion to the drivetrain or the aspiration. We can't actually do an engine swap to this vehicle. Interesting. Interesting indeed. So we can swap in twin turbos. Honestly, as a standard, it's got a displacement supercharger. So I'm going to say supercharger right now, to me, sounds the most exciting. Like, the sound was incredible. I don't really want to change that. Now, we can also play around with the fitment of this car, which is just so bizarre to me. Actually, I say that, it kind of needs it. So let's fix that fitment. I say fix it. Do we ruin it or actually fix it? That actually looks like it fits spot on now that we've put it
on the full setting, so I'm going to stick with that. The wheels, fine. Don't need to change them. We do have tire adjustments that we can do. We can give it even more grip. But quite honestly, do we want to? Because again, it's driving pretty damn well. Now, engine upgrades are available, so we're going to throw in these. What my hope is that if we throw in these engine parts, is it actually going to stay about the same stability? Is it going to keep the control that it had before? That we're going to have to find out. Of course, the brakes need to be upgraded because we upgraded the power. In fact, actually, did that make the brakes smaller? It actually made the brakes smaller. We have dual calipers at the rear and the Forza brakes somehow still improve it. I think not, to be honest with you. Come on, we're going to go for it. We're going to make the tires thick, and that's everything we can actually do to this vehicle. There's nothing more other than the twin turbos, which of course would be quite fun to try. Yep, he's doing it. Back in Broadway. Is Broadway actually where we held our car meet? It might have actually been. We held one here. It was pretty cool. All right, let's get it. We now have turbos instead of superchargers. The gears are begging to be altered, but I don't know if I want to alter anything about this car. Oh, I may have ruined it. So we do have that front grip still properly playing with us here. It forever wanting to grip up and go forwards, which is beautiful. It feels so, so good. But would I say turbos are better than supercharger? I don't, honestly, it doesn't really make much difference. I feel the biggest difference is probably to the lightening of the car that we did. Doing the lightening and a bit more performance, realistically, on the same tune. We're going to have some changes to the vehicle's playability and how it's going to go. And just going to ignore that mini roundabout completely. But I think we can all agree it sounds amazing inside. No matter which type of boost you go for. Oh, I feel like I want to go back in though and put the supercharger up again. I think we're going to build our final ultimate build. I think I might put the weight back on, honestly. And then reduce it back down to the top of its actual class. Because normally in the case of Forza, we've got S2922. We could of course keep that, but then we can't go any further than that. So it's a bit of a weird place to be in. So I'm going to go to the top of S1 and build me ultimate mobile. Supercharger reinstalled, and straight away we've brought it down into different classes. In fact, we could actually have got some extra performance by decreasing that. We're going to go for lowering the pistons. I think we'll actually have to lower pretty much all of it. Yeah, we're going to have to do some proper tweaking here. So power back down to basically standard. Tires, they're not playing that major of a part, to be honest. Can we actually get this to build to S1? Weight reduction removed, and we're now down to S1. But I kind of want to try and see if we can tick over just to max it out. What about the pistons? I think the pistons is what we're going to go for. We've got it as we want it. Right. It's perfect now. Honestly, it could have stayed perfect if you left it as it was, but oh yeah, I feel it's a lot more confident again now. We reduced it down, so I think if you want to stay with the standard tune, because I don't really want to mess with a tune that's already perfect. And we can't really get that much more power out of it, so realistically it's not really worth touching it that much in my opinion. But this feels really, really good. It's all down to the tune in Forza, I tell you. All it is, it's about how you toggle them switches, play with them just a wee little bit, and you get the most confident feeling car ever. And it looks amazing. It has a massive whack. I think other than roundabouts, the UK is not an amazing place in terms of drift areas. I think the best drift area is probably the Islands DLC that they released, and probably some of the areas on Lego. Of course, you get these areas like this actually are pretty darn cool, to say the very least. I do wish they made use of them, made more like Gymkhana style events. I think that would be perfect for the game, considering that they know now that their audience, they must know that most of their audience like to do quite a few skids. And making use of these areas would be pretty damn fun. Just like imagine a showcase event where you just gotta pull off some mad skids and the like. Would I recommend getting this car? I mean, it's pretty easy. You do three events, you can change the difficulty, you can make it as easy as you want. Well, I say as easy as you want. Not quite as easy as you want, but you can make it quite significantly a bit easier. And then you can allow yourself to get this car pretty darn easily. And it's a nice one to have in the collection. As I say, when it comes to cars like this, they handle better when they've set them up. Now, whether they do something vastly different, which is probably what they do, they set them up to be proper drift cars. And then when you start driving some of the standard cars again, you're like, what? Why is it not drifting the same? It's kind of like, well, there's just something about a freshly made, clean Ferrari made for Formula D. with an insane supercharger noise going for it as well. I love this car. I think this would be a cool area to have a proper drift event. Just points-based drifting on Forza Horizon 4. We already know it's available on Forza Motorsport. Why isn't it available here other than online? Because I like drifting solo. I don't know if anyone agrees with me, but to me, drifting solo is the place to be. I was considering changing the livery of the car, but when it comes to taking all these liveries off, I just couldn't do it. I just couldn't do it. It makes it that little bit more special. It makes it a proper official race car, opposed to just a, you know, no visual mods, nothing really changed, just down to business, and a standard looking Ferrari with a wide body, to be fair. So that is quite significant. All right, my friends, be sure to smash that like button, subscribe if you're new for more Forza Horizon 4. That sounds quite strange. Until next time, my friends. Peace.